This is the BMW M2 CS, and it should be brilliant. Why? Well, BMW has had ample practice at getting its baby M car right. First with the regular M2 in 2016, and then the M2 competition that followed 2 years later. There's another reason too. When the CS was launched, its M4 bigger brother was out of production between the F82 and G82 models. This meant BMW had no reason to hold the M2 back. No longer any worry about treading on the more expensive car's toes. In other words, the M2 CS is the no-holds-barred M2 unleashed. But here's the thing. It costs £75,000. That's almost 50% more than an M2 competition, a car that many believe to be one of the finest BMW driving machines of the past decade, and one that we gave a coveted 5-star rating to. Charging that much more for the CS suggests incredible things, but it also brings with it a whole new set of expectations and rivals. So, how much better is the M2 CS over its cheaper competition sibling, and is it really worth £75,000? First impressions are contradictory. From the outside, this car looks like a serious piece of kit, what with its striking Misano blue paint job, carbon details, and forged jet black wheels. And then, once you climb inside, you'll see more carbon, swathes of Alcantara, and the very obvious absence of an armrest, which, of course, you don't mind because this is a proper performance car.
But then you begin to notice things that don't quite fit in with that, like the indulgent leather seats that are both fully electric and heated. And when you turn the car on, it sounds grumbly and muted, just like an M2 competition, in fact. It even defaults to the economy engine mode every time you start it up. Those expecting to see an immediate return from their additional £23,000 investment over the M2 competition might be feeling a little bit worried at this point. Sure, it looks incredible, but what exactly is lying underneath? Well, for starters, adaptive dampers are fitted as standard for the first time on the M2 and offer 3 expertly judged settings.
Driving across your standard bumpy B road, and the comfort and even sport modes are noticeably more pliant than the fixed setup on the M2 competition. It never feels as though it's skipping across the road surface. Instead, it's gently massaging it with minimal fuss. If you go over a crest at a slight angle, you can feel the exact moment that the car is at its lightest before it flows back down again and hunkers those perfect proportions back onto the road surface. The body control in general is utterly superb.
Speaking of proportions, the M2 CS has the same track width as its siblings, yet because of the beefier body kit, it comes in at 17mm wider than the competition. And yet, it's still the rare thing of a high-powered sports car that doesn't feel too wide for your average country road. You can place it with confidence without having to wince every time a car comes the other way.
It just feels very together, very taut. The carbon strut brace at the front is partly to thank for that, but there are other things too.
For example, that carbon roof. It would be easy to put it down as a purely cosmetic addition, but it actually shaves off 6.5 kilograms from the very top of the car, bringing down the center of gravity and making the whole structure stiffer. There's also the optional lighter carbon brakes, taking unsprung mass off each corner, and grippier Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2 tyres that provide sensational sticking power in the dry.
These aren't dramatic changes, they're more incremental additions to just tighten everything up. But the important bit is you can feel the difference. This is the BMW M2 Competition Plus. Being honest, there's still not a great deal of feel through the steering, but it doesn't take away from the incredible agility of this front end. It's helped by a super quick rack, but it's not excessive. And crucially,
There's a sense of cohesion in the chassis that you just don't always get with other sports cars.
It's not hard to have super fast steering, but in many cars the rear end can't keep up with the speed of the movement at the front. The M2 CS isn't like that. Turn in and it feels like that short wheelbase is literally pivoting around its axis.
And of course, with some deliberate steering inputs and a good prod of the throttle, the rear end is more than happy to start sliding. You've got to be quick to catch it because of that short wheelbase, but the always helpful MDM mode means you can have plenty of slip, enjoy that active M differential, and then fall back on the DSC safety net if things get a little bit crazy. And if you want to spend an extra £6,000 on top of the standard list price, then the carbon brakes are a way to do that. The stopping power they generate is absolutely superb, but the pedal feel, it takes some getting used to, like a lot of carbon brakes, and for road driving, the standard ones will probably do the job just as well.
You might be wondering why I haven't spoken about the engine yet, and that's because it hasn't really changed all that much over the M2 competition. Sure, there's an extra 39 brake horsepower, but because the curb weight remains the same at 1550 kilograms, real-world gains aren't huge.
It is very fast. 0-62 miles an hour takes just 4 seconds with the DCT gearbox, but you only truly notice the difference as you're chasing that 7,000 RPM red line and the peakier power delivery really hits home. There is, though, enough low-down muscle to help you power out of corners on a decent wave of torque, if that's what you happen to fancy. I just wish that the noise this car made was as special as how it looks from the outside. I know it's not going to sound like a BMW 1M, but even if you compare it with a Cayman GT4 or even a Cayman GTS, both with the 4-litre flat-six engine, it's just nowhere near as spine-tingling or evocative.
We need to put all of this into context, though. The CS is indeed the ultimate M2, a fantastic sports car. But is it worth an extra £23,000, almost 50% more than the M2 competition?
Now, of course, if you have an endless budget, then £75,000 doesn't sound like that much. And it's the same if only the ultimate BMW will do for you. But for the rest of us, I don't think this CS does enough to justify the extra money over the already brilliant M2 competition.
There's no denying that incremental improvements have been made across the board, yet it feels as if without stricter weight saving and a more single-minded approach, there's only so much more you can add to the already brilliant competition model. Keeping the M2 CS as usable as possible will no doubt appeal to a broader customer base, yet it comes at the expense of making what could have been something truly special.
I said at the start of this video that this was supposed to be the M2 Unleashed, and it's a brilliant car, but it's civilized and relatively polite. For a final run-out model, surely it could have been more focused. It could have been something to really beat the Cayman GT4 at its own game. That would have been what the M2 really deserved.